As of Chapter 6, we vaguely have some sort of idea what Grimm is. He's a dire beast presumably mixed with a cat, most likely a warrior cat from Shadow Clan. We know he's mixed with some kind of animal, but with one question answered, we get several more questions to replace it. Why does Grimm have some sort of spell placed on him? We don't have a lot of obvious clues in that direction, but I have kind of a crazy speculative idea. Although love is love and all of that, I don't think Grimm is a natural result of a dire beast and a cat. Sorry, I'm thinking of that Full Metal Alchemist meme where it's like yaoi couple, yuri couple. I hate that meme. I think he was purposely bred that way, and I know it sounds crazy, but I think he was bred and placed under a spell as an ancient solution to Blot containment or something related to Blot. I know that's a wild claim, but just walk with me for a bit on this one. Grimm has insanely good Blot resistance. Even with the weird episodes he's had, Idias says that his Blot levels fluctuate wildly and will get to the point where he would be a phantom, but he's fine. He doesn't turn into one. He's been able to eat several Blot stones and for the most part be okay. Blot is highly, highly toxic to humans. It's said if you even touch it, it will cause problems. I think it would probably kill you or at the very least make you incredibly sick if a human tried eating it, but Grimm hasn't died. He's had episodes, yeah, and I do have a theory about that, but I need to set some framework, so we'll get back to that. His Blot levels aren't the only reason I think he was some experiment in Blot containment. Who's the first to notice the Blot stone after Odysseus and him defeat the dwarf phantom? It was Grimm. Who says he has a great talent for digging and then is able to not just pinpoint a Blot stone, but also dig it up after a stone stage was completely fixed up and it was presumably like buried in there? It was Grimm. I think Grimm has some sort of attraction to Blot stones or was bred or trained to have skills to locate them even in the hardest conditions. It also gives a more concrete answer as to why Grimm likes Blot stones and they aren't bitter or gross to him. He was designed that way. It's not just some monster thing. It was a purposeful trait so he could want to eat Blot stones and safely dispose of them so humans wouldn't have to. And if he was designed to dispose of Blot for humans, it would make sense why Blot treatments wouldn't work on him. He's supposed to take on Blot. He doesn't need treatments. It's mentioned in the story that sometimes phantoms pass as dire beasts and live in the forests. However, I don't think that's what's going on with Grimm. Six regularly deals with phantoms. Even if they can't easily analyze ancient magic, they would be able to figure out if Grimm was part phantom. And because they said he's a dire beast mix, I'm going to trust them because phantoms are a specialty of theirs. Six has been around for centuries and they've been doing stuff all this time. We also have heard that the arcane magic the wizard cops will intervene with overblots. It's possible that Grimm was an experimental Blot containment alternative to either of these, or maybe even a first attempt at one. Because let's be real here, overblots are terrifying enough. Sticks and pigs would not exactly help the fear. Grimm, although he is a big boy, would be a lot less intimidating. And as much as I love roasting him, he is pretty adorable. My framework is now laid, so let's talk about Grimm's episodes and his curse. In my opinion, Grimm's episodes are a result of him not being the perfect end product that his experimenters wanted. He's not perfect at Blot containment and lashes out after too many stones, so he stopped getting used for it. It would also explain why he was seemingly abandoned. He's a failed test subject. That being said, if I'm right in my assumptions, I think the spell placed on Grimm is probably what helps him regulate Blot and not go berserk right off the bat. It's possible he did rampage like a phantom in the past, and this spell is keeping him in a relatively harmless, sane form. But if experimentation happened, I would imagine the spell is more linked to that, since, as far as we know, dire beasts don't have any sort of, like, built-in immunity to Blot, so it was probably something put onto Grimm. What's going on with Grimm is still unfolding, so all we can really do is guess as we get crumbs of lore. And while this is all speculation, I don't know, it just stuck in my brain, I randomly thought about it, and I was like, huh, that would be interesting. It wouldn't be the first time Yana's written about experimentation in the first place, I mean, that's kind of a big plot point in Black Butler. Once again, thank you everyone for watching my videos. If you would like to support me beyond liking and subscribing and all of that, I have a Patreon and I also have channel memberships. If you like live streaming, I live stream over on Twitch every Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday. And yeah, bye, shameless plug over.